Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, Miss Shea Butter. Hope you guys are, you know, feeling good and everything. So today's video is gonna be a little different. Today I am going to be interviewing one of my good friends. I pretty much want to shed awareness on people that have serious diseases or an illness, and just to share some of the things that we all go through. It doesn't matter, you know, if you have cancer, what kind of cancer you have, breast cancer, lung cancer, Hodgkin's lymphoma, if you have sickle cell, if you have, it could be leukemia, anything like that. So today I have one of my good friends. Her name is Ro. She does have sickle cell anemia, SS, and today I'm just gonna be asking her a few questions, you know, and we're just gonna be shedding light on just some of the similar things that we both go through and that, you know, people need to know. So hey Ro. Okay, Ro, so I see right now that you are currently at the hospital. Can you tell all of us, why are you in the hospital right now?
So I'm in the hospital for a sickle cell crisis, and I have been waiting since 1:10 a.m. It is now probably like 3:30 a.m. They just put my IV in like 15 minutes ago. I haven't had any pain medicine, no antibiotic. Well, I don't need antibiotics, I'm just talking, no fluids, that's what I meant. They didn't ask me what I take or anything, so. And this is an issue. This is a very big issue, because when you have sickle cell, okay, I'm pretty sure this goes for a lot of people that have sickle cell, like what I'm about to say. When you have sickle cell, you have to make the decision to go to the hospital. Like when, which one, what time, because if you let your pain progress, if you say, no, I'm okay, I can stay home, I can handle this pain, it's good, and it gets worse where you can't walk, you can barely talk, you're screaming, you're crying because you're in so much pain, and you get to the hospital and you're in all that pain and you have to wait 2 hours, 3 hours in the hospital, that's an issue. So I used to do that, and it was torture because I used to hate going to the hospital. It's an event, it's not fun. You get stuck 3-4 times if someone does not know what they're doing. You have to wait all day, all night, and it's just not fun.
Wow, I can't believe that. Well, actually, I can't believe that you've been sitting here that long, because just coming from experience, when I used to be in the hospital, you know, they would tell me that I'll have to wait, and they'll just have me sitting here for hours in pain, granted, especially when I first got diagnosed, because I was in pain on stage 3, and they would just have me sit there because they're like, oh, well, we don't know exactly what you have, so we can't give you this, da, da, da. But I'm sitting there for the longest. I definitely understand your pain. So, Ro, what is, can you describe to us what is, like, your pain level right now? Like, how are you feeling and everything?
My pain right now is very manageable. Like, I can manage my pain, but the only reason I came in is because my pain is going to keep coming back. So, my sickle cell, I only get sick when I get my period. So, I know other people that get sick whenever. I used to be one of those people that just would get sick whenever. But now I only get sick when I get my period. So it's just like a gamble. Like, okay, you can stay home, you can treat it, or you can go and get medical attention as far as pain medicine and IV fluids, and then you'll be good to go for that month. Okay. Like I said, I've been waiting for like 2.5 hours and nothing. Nothing. So imagine if my pain was unbearable. That has happened to me before. It does not make them go any faster. Actually, it causes a lot of tension because they're like, oh, she's screaming, she's crying, she's showing out, she just wants attention. When the actual truth is that I feel like my body is ripping itself apart. And I have to wait to get pain medicine. I'm not trying to hear that. And it's crazy.
That is definitely ridiculous. It's sad how hospitals, you know, treat people. We don't want to be here in the hospital. I mean, you do have those people who do abuse, you know, the system, and they come in and they want to, you know, get medication to get high. But the people who are actually in the hospital, and granted, you guys diagnosed us with this illness or disease, and it's like, but you still don't believe us on how we feel, that we're really in pain, and that I don't want to sit here and wait until you guys say it's okay. I need something now to cure my pain. And I think that's something that we definitely both share. Granted, when I was in the hospital, they would just say, oh, I would be going through a bunch of nausea, or I wouldn't want to get chemotherapy that day because I'm constantly throwing up time after time. Like, it's just the chemotherapy is flushing through my body, coming through my body, and this stuff is just making me throw up. I'm throwing up every 10, 15 minutes. I'm feeling weak. I can't eat anything. But they're like, oh, well, there's nothing we really can do. We can give you these little pills or anything like that. And granted, that stuff don't work, or it just makes it worse, which I have found out that most of the medication they try to give me for nausea or pain, it just made everything worse. And it just sucks, you know? And so I also wanted to ask you too, Ro, how do you think like society, or just the hospital in general, looks at you personally as someone that has sickle cell, and when you come in and you need treatment or medication to help with your pain? And if you can just explain, describe to us, you know, how you feel about
that. I'm not sure. You know, because some people, they say, oh, we're paranoid, or oh, we're overreacting. But a lot of hospitals look at people with sickle cell as drug users and drug abusers. And because you don't come in here, it's like you damned if you do and you damned if you don't. If you come in here screaming and crying and hollering, they're going to say, oh, you're making a scene. Oh, she wants attention. Oh, it's not that bad. Oh, stand up. You can do it. It's not that bad. And if you come in here how I am right now, they're going to say, oh, well, she's not in pain at all. She's just here because she wants some medicine. And it's like, if you don't have sickle cell, you do not know. And I wish, like, I don't wish the pain on no one. But I do want people to know how this feels.
It's like, pretty much, you will never know how this feel or experience it unless you really have it. So that's definitely explainable.
So I guess I do wish this pain on people, but not to permanently have it, just for 5 minutes.
5 minutes.
All you need is 5 minutes. If you could feel this pain for 5 minutes, then you would know, like, oh my God, this is unlike anything I have ever felt in my life. Like, it's just, I can't compare it to anything that someone without sickle cell experiences. I just can't. It's not compared to a headache. I've never been shot, but I'm pretty sure it's not compared to being shot. I also don't have kids, but I'm pretty sure it's not compared to giving birth. Like, I am that confident to say that.
Okay, Ro, so I know that right now you are waiting and that your pain right now is bearable, but I don't want to hold you up. I really appreciate, you know, you being able to just record and talk to us and share your experience and knowledge on this. The last question I do want to ask you is, how does this make you feel at your age? Granted, I mean, you're an adult, but you are still young, you know, so how does this make you feel, and what kind of impact that has on you?
You know, as an adult, it's so hard because you don't have priority. And I understand everybody has their own situation and they're going through everything, but when you are in a sickle cell crisis, like right now, I don't mind not having priority because I'm pretty sure it's other people that's maybe suffering a little bit more than I am, but I am still in pain. It's just a pain that I can bear. But if my pain was higher, no, this is unacceptable. Like, if you're going to be waiting all day and all night, you can stay home. You can stay home. They don't want to give us medicine. It's just terrible. It's terrible. And just imagine sitting and waiting in excruciating pain. They let people go before you. It's sickening. And you know what? We are drug seekers because 99.9% of the time, when you're in a severe sickle cell crisis, the only thing that will help you is narcotics. IV narcotics. The pain will not go away with pills, with narcotic pills. No, that's like child's play to us. Okay, you have to understand, people who have sickle cell have had this their entire lives. Like, we were born with this. So when you take a pill, that's nothing. That's child's play. So hopefully they come in here soon with my medication and I can go home, because that's the plan. But until then, I will be patiently.
Well, it looks like Ro had to go, but I just want to say thank you, girl, for, you know, coming out here and just, well, you know, granted, getting on camera and sharing all of that knowledge with us and just, you know, telling people, coming from somebody who's experiencing it. It means a lot, and especially to those people out there who's dealing with sickle cell right now and they don't have those people to speak out and share how they're feeling. Granted, we are all going through the same thing, and you know, girl, you are a fighter. Yes, we are fighters. And like I said, thank you again. You know, I really hope they get to you. They need to get to you. Don't let me have to come down here, okay? But so everybody, that concludes today's video for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this interview with me and my friend Ro. You can go and follow her on her Instagram. Also, if there is any other, you know, information that you want to ask her about or anything, I will list her information in the description box. Also, yep, so I hope you guys enjoyed this interview. I hope you guys took something from it. And just remember, like, it doesn't matter what illness you have, what disease you have. Granted, we are all fighting, and that's what's important. We are all fighting for, you know, the one thing, and that is to get better. That is to be better. You know, we don't want to stay in the hospitals. You know, we don't want to live our life, granted, going to the hospital day after day or feeling weak, feeling, you know, just not ourselves. Nobody wants to deal with that. So we need to come together as just survivors and fighters right now to cure this problem of how hospitals treat us when we are there and when we're getting treated, and how they look upon each disease or illness differently. We are all going through the same thing. Granted, yes, I'm not saying that there's not any illnesses or diseases that are, you know, more extreme than others. There are. But all I'm saying is that we all deserve to be treated the same as far as making sure that we're able to have access to that medication and treatment that we need in a need of time and pain that we're going through, you know? But I'm done here, guys, for today. Make sure you like and subscribe to this video, okay? And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.